to Les Grandes Show Productions in this performance of August, Osage County. Please take this time to turn off all cell phones and any other electronic devices you may have, as they can disturb the performers on stage and your fellow patrons. Also, for your safety, as the auditorium can be extremely dark, please remain in your seats until the end of each of the three acts and the house lights turn on. This production will run approximately 3 hours with 2 10-minute interventions. Now, sit back and relax as we return to the Oklahoma Plains. Enjoy the show.
Something has been said for sobriety, but very little. Betterment again.
Now you with him.
Place is in such bad shape.
Not yet.
Well, I've done all right. I
managed. Just last night, I burned an awful lot of free.
No. A simple utility bill can mean so much to a living person. Once they pass, after they pass, numbers and words just seem like otherworldly symbols. It's only paper. It's worse than blank paper. Oh, this is clean.
Thank you.
I apologize for the temperature in here. My wife is cold-blooded, not just in a metaphorical sense. She does not believe in average. As if it's something to be disbelieved.
My dad goes to see me. I'm used to it.
I knew Mr. Younger, you know.
You knew Dad?
It's a small town. I bought many water from his great step. Sometimes he sold fireworks, too, right?
Yes, sir.
Bought Roman candles for children. Did pass, didn't he?
Yes, sir.
May I ask how?
He had a heart attack. Fell out of the flatbed truck with wine grapes.
Wine grapes? You know for the moment. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
May I ask about the name? Well, he was Youngbird, and you are?
Bonavata.
Bonavata.
I went back to the original language.
And does it mean Young Bird?
Yes.
And taking the name, that was your choice. Cheers. By night, within that ancient house, immense, black, damned, anonymous.
Bad!
Yes?
Did you polish?
What?
Did you?
What, dear?
Oh, God, did you? Are the police here?
No.
Is this a window? Am I looking through window? A window?
Can you come here?
Careful! You're the house muscular.
Why don't you go back to bed, sweetheart?
Why don't you go fuck a fucking sow's ass?
All right.
I'm sorry. I'll be sickly sweet. I'm so sweet. In L.A. Sweet.
Here we go round the prickly pear, the prickly pear, the prickly pear. Here we go round the prickly pear. And by the
don't want to feel your back.
I feel it. Sweat is just dripping down my back.
I believe you. shades, taping up the shades.
Well, that's in a couple of years now.
Has it been that long since we've been here?
You know its purpose.
You can't tell if it's night or day.
I think that's the purpose.
I don't think, I don't know about you, but I don't think it's healthy.
It's not. You need sunlight.
Do you know which one of them decided on doing this?
I can't really see Dad taking the initiative.
No, I suppose not. I know about you, you know, but I find this whole setup depressing. You know, a person's environment. Hey, what the hell? Eric Clapton album, Vice Clapton fan? Well, don't do that.
The body needs sunlight.
It's not time to miss this into a place. You can't go into somebody's home and start changing.
Do you believe we haven't been here in 2 years?
He said he checked all the hospitals. No, Beverly.
This is the highway patrol.
No, not the highway patrol. Sheriff, the Gilmo boy.
Gilmo. Don't tell me C.J. Gilmo's the sheriff. Here.
Not C.J., his boy, Dion.
I was going to say.
He went to school with the girls, Dion did.
Was he in your class, Anne?
Barbara's class, I think.
Is that right?
Who is this now?
C.J. Gilmo's this boy we grew up with. Mean little son of a bitch. Juvenile delinquent.
Well, his boy, Dion, is the sheriff here now.
C.J. was the preacher's son, and you know.
Go say no more.
And you know how they are.
Well, you remember. He went to the penitentiary.
Yes, I remember that. It was for killing, what was it?
A boxer.
Right, for killing this man's boxer dog.
Well, his boy Dion's the sheriff now. I sent you that subscription to the Pawhuska Journal Capital. Don't you read it?
No, I don't read it.
So you told some big shots to keep up with the small town folk.
No, I don't read it.
Well, if you read it, you know that his boy Dion is the sheriff here now.
What hospitals did they check?
Oh, he rattled off a bunch of them.
What else did he say?
The boat's missing.
Mom.
He sent a patrolman down to the docks to check if anyone had seen him, and Beverly's pontoon boat is gone.
Oh, no.
He said they had some boats stolen in the last little while, so he didn't think it meant anything. But he's worried about it.
Why, you think he has a chance Beverly loaded the boat onto the trailer and took it out of there? I mean, if it was going somewhere else.
Uh-uh, trailer's out by the shed. I saw it when we pulled up.
Oh, excuse me, dear. Can I trouble you for another beer?
God damn it, she's not a waitress.
I know that.
You better get your own beer.
Okay.
I don't believe you. Sitting here watching the baseball game and drinking beers. Don't you have any sense of what's going on around you? The situation is for what?
Am I supposed to sit here like a statue? You're drinking whiskey.
I'm having a cocktail.
You're drinking straight whiskey.
Just show a little class.
No. Why we have to sit here crying in the dark?
Well, since you got everything all figured out, let's party down.
Okay.
Get the kid down and whip us up some cheese conies and let's call a few friends.
Ooh, cheese conies sounds good.
Ooh, it does, doesn't it? You smell something cooking?
Yeah.
Ooh, come with me to the kitchen. Let's see what it is.
You don't need me. I got the oils on.
Uh-huh. Just come with me.
That's not good news about that boat.
Did you call Barb?
Yeah.
When'd you call her?
This morning.
What'd she say?
She and Bill are coming.
How's she getting here? Is she driving?
I don't think so.
What?
Boulder's a long way.
Is she bringing Jean?
I don't know.
Well, when did she say she'd get here?
She didn't say. She just said she was on her way.
What did you tell her?
I told her Dad was missing.
That's all.
Is there anything else?
Well, did you tell her how long he'd been missing?
5 days.
You tell her that?
I think so.
Well, what'd she say?
She said she was on her way.
God damn it, Ivy. What did she say? Was she irritated? Was she amused? Tell me what she said.
She said she was on her way.
Oh, you are horrible. God damn your father. Put me through this, leaving me to handle this. You seen that office of his, all that paperwork, that mess? I can't make head or tail of it. He hired this Indian a week ago for some goddamn reason, and now I got a stranger in my house. I don't know what to say to that girl. What's her name?
Jonna.
He always paid the bills and made the phone calls. Now suddenly I'm supposed to do it? You know this place is falling apart. Something about the basement of the sump pump or the foundation. I can't do this by myself.
I called Karen.
What'd she say?
She said she'd try to get here.
She'll be a big freaking help, just like you. I need Barb.
I don't know what Barb's gonna be able to do.
What'd you do to your hair?
I had it straightened.
You had it straightened. Now why would anybody do something like that?
I don't know.
Why did you do it?
I just wanted a change.
You're a pretty girl. You're the prettiest of my three girls. Yet you always look like such a schlub. Why don't you wear any makeup?
Do I need makeup?
All women need makeup. Don't let anyone tell you different. The only woman pretty enough not to use makeup was Elizabeth Taylor. She wore a ton. Sit up straight. Oh, your hands all straight, your shoulders are slumped, and you don't wear makeup. You look like a goddamn lesbian. You could get a decent enough man if you would just spruce up a bit. That's all I'm saying.
Not looking for a man.
Well, you should be. Everybody needs someone.
I'm not looking for a man.
Listen, there are a lot of losers out there. Don't think I don't know that. But just because you got a bad one.
Barry wasn't a loser.
Barry was an asshole. And I warned you right from the start, didn't I? First time you brought him by in that ridiculous little electric car with that stupid orange beard and that turban.
It wasn't a turban.
I just don't understand some of the choices you're making. You're 43 years old. 44 years old. Maybe you're past the point of having children. That's okay if you don't want any. But aren't you interested in finding a husband?
A husband, a husband.
You don't meet people where you live, you meet them where you work. You work in a college. You can't tell me there aren't people walking through the doors of that library every day.
You want me to marry a student? Some 18-year-old boy from one of these hick towns?
They still have teachers on the Tulsa campus, don't they? They did when your father taught there.
Barry was a teacher at TU.
Yeah. Environmental studies. Barry was a loser.
Wasn't a loser.
Well, he dumped you, didn't he? My mind, that makes him
he
a loser.
He did not dump me. Just didn't work out between us.
All right. All right. I'm sorry. I'll try to get it straight. I'm sorry. Maybe things would have worked out between you if you'd worn a little makeup. How many was that?
I wasn't counting.
Oh.
Is your mouth hurting?
Like a son of a bitch. My tongue is on fire.
Are you supposed to be smoking?
Is anyone supposed to smoke?
You have cancer of the mouth.
I have enough on my mind right this minute without you getting on me about my smoking.
I'm not getting on you.
Just leave it alone.
Are you scared?
Of course I'm scared. You are a comfort to me, sweetheart. Thank God one of my daughters stayed close to home. My generation, family stayed together.
That was a different time.
No kidding. Did you call Maddie Faye?
Aunt Maddie Faye's here.
I know that, dummy. Did you call her?
I thought you called her.
Yes, I did. I don't remember.
You got a lot on your mind.
She needs to come here and tell me what's what.
I don't know how Uncle Charlie puts up with it.
Well, he smokes a lot of grass.
He does?
He smokes a lot of grass.
Grass? You say grass.
Well, what do you call it?
Hey, are you into Clapton now?
What?
Eric Clapton. Keep cutting Eric Clapton album.
Oh, I have had that forever.
I've never seen it.
I like it. It's got a good beat. I'm not old, you know.
What's Jean doing?
Smoking.
Wish you wouldn't encourage that.
I haven't encouraged any.
I don't know, just something a little funny about the way you say smoking, like you admire her for getting hooked at 14.
Are you ready for this?
No, no way.
Take a second.
God damn, it's hot.
Wimp.
Why do it? Colorado spoiled me.
One of the reasons we got out of here.
No, it's not.
Hey, you suppose your mother's turned on the air conditioner?
Are you kidding me? I mean, you remember the parakeets.
Parakeets?
I didn't tell you about the parakeets. She bought a parakeet for some insane reason, and the little fucker croaked after about 2 days. So she went to the pet store, raised hell, and they gave her a second parakeet. That one died after just 1 day. So she went back, got another. That one died too. So the chick from the pet store came over to see just what in the hell this serial parakeet killer was doing to bump off all these birds.
And?
The heat. It was too hot. They were dying from the heat.
Jesus.
I mean, these are tropical birds, right? They live in the fucking tropics. What were these people thinking?
What people?
The jokers who settled this place? The Dutch, the Irish, the Germans. I mean, who was the asshole who saw this flat, hot nothing and planted his flag? I mean, we fucked the Indians for this.
Well, you know what they say. Genocide always seems like such a good idea.
At the time.
Right, but you always need a little hindsight.
Anyway, if you want me to explain the creepy character in the Midwest, you were asking the wrong.
Please, please, no, this is not the Midwest, okay? Michigan is the Midwest, God knows why. This is the plains. A state of mind, right? Some spiritual affliction, like the blues.
You okay? I'm fine. I just have planes.
Don't. What is she doing? Smoking a fucking cigar?
She's coming. Okay. Ready, sweetheart?
Yeah, sure. You're precious. Okay. Sorry, clock ledge. Okay. Here goes. Mom?
Oh my God, what happened?
Hey,
give me some sugar. Oh,
hi, Bill.
Hi.
What do you want? Oh my goodness. Hey, look at this one. Oh, come give your Aunt Betty Faye some sugar. Oh.
Hello, Charlie.
Hello, Bill, man. You know, you have lost some weight, haven't you?
My gosh, you're so big. And look at your big boobs. They're so big. Last time I saw you, you looked like a little boy.
Hello,
oh,
sweetheart.
See you.
Lovely to see you, dear.
Same here.
Same here. Same
oh,
here.
Barbara!
Okay, Mom. It's okay. I'm here. It's okay.
You heard that? No.
No, I'm alright. Okay, I'm here.
What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do?
We can talk about that, okay? Have you seen Bill and Jean?
Yes. Ha, Bill.
Violet, I'm sorry you're going through this.
I'm just so scared.
Of course you are, poor thing. Bill, you've lost too much weight.
Pardon?
Oh, yes, you have.
Oh, and look at you, girl.
Now, isn't she something else? Look at her boobs.
Okay, we all stare at my tits now.
And they're just so darn big.
Aren't you big? The prettiest thing. Thank you. Me.
No problem. Ivy, I didn't see you up there.
It looked crowded.
God, you look good. Doesn't she look good, Bill?
Yes, she does.
I love what you did with your hair. It
she had it straightened.
I know. It looks great. Ivy. Hi.
Barbara. Or Bill, it doesn't matter. I need you to go through Beverly's office and help me with some of that paperwork.
I said I would do that.
No. Now, that office is such a mess. And I get to
I'll take care of it.
Which room are you guys staying in?
We're headed back tonight.
You're headed back?
We have to, Vi. We left in such a rush we didn't get anyone to look after those damn dogs.
You're going to drive that hour and a half tonight?
Not the way Charlie drives. Anyway, I know you want to spend some time with these girls.
Well, can't you call someone to take care of the dogs? What about little Charles? Can't he take care of the dogs?
Yes, he could. No, he can't either. We have to get back.
Maybe we should call him in.
We talked about this.
I know.
We have all these people here and just not enough beds.
Well, you could stay at Abby's place. Well,
yeah, sure. I've got room.
We talked about this.
Y'all can figure that out on your own, okay? Mom, Jean can stay in the attic.
No. That's where what's her name stays.
Tana. Who's John?
She's an Indian that lives in my attic.
She's the what?
Hi, I'm John. Welcome home.
Thank you.
Saturday morning, that girl, that Indian girl, made us some biscuits and gravy. We ate some. He walked out the door, that door right there, and that was it.
And that was the last time you saw him?
I went to bed Saturday night, got up Sunday morning, still no Beverly. I didn't make much of it, though. I just thought he'd gone on a bender.
Why would he do that? It's not like you couldn't drink at home unless you were riding his ass.
I never said a word to him about his drinking. Never got on him about it.
Really?
Oh, Barbara, I swear, he could drink himself into oblivion.
Oblivion.
So, Sunday, still no sign?
That's right, Sunday, still no sign. And I started to get a little worried, don't you know? That's when I got all worked up about that safety deposit box. We kept an awful lot of money in that box. And jewelry, expensive jewelry. Well, I had a diamond ring in that box and raised it over $7,000.
Well, I'm missing something. Why do we care about the safety deposit box?
Well, I know what you'll say about this. But your father and I had an urgent arrangement. If something were to happen to one of us, the other would go and empty out that box.
They get rolled into the estate, then it goes to probate.
Right, that's right.
Fucking
oh, I knew you'd disagree.
Okay, fine. So what about the safety deposit box?
Well, I had to wait for the bank to open on Monday so I could get into that safety deposit box. And after I emptied the box, I called the sheriff and reported it missing Monday morning.
And you're just now calling me today, on Thursday.
I didn't call you.
Well, you had Ivy call 5 days later.
I didn't want to worry.
Son of a bitch!
Violet, are you sure there wasn't some event that triggered his leaving, some incident?
You mean like a fight?
Yes.
No. No, we fought enough, you know. But there was nothing. He just left.
Maybe he needed to get away from you.
That's nice of you to say.
Hey, that's no crime. Being married is hard.
Under the best of circumstances.
But nothing. Not see you again, or I'm taking a walk.
That man. When I first fell in love with, you know, was his mystery. I thought he was sexy as hell. You knew he was the smartest one in the room. Knew that if he would just say something, knock you out. But he'd just stay in there, little smile on his face, not say a word. Sexy.
Yeah, that mystery. A cup of like.
Violet, there wasn't anything different or unusual or...
He hired this woman. Didn't ask me, just hired this woman to come in and live in our house a few days before we left.
But you don't want her here.
I don't know what she's doing here. She's a stranger in my home. There's an Indian living in my home.
What's the matter? You have a problem with Indians, Violet?
I don't know what to say to an Indian.
They're called Native Americans now, Paul.
Who calls them that? Who makes that decision?
It's what they like to be called.
Well, they aren't any more native than me.
In fact, they are.
What's wrong with Indian?
Why is it so hard just to call people what they want to be called?
Oh, let's just call the dinosaurs Native Americans while we're at it.
Well, she may be an Indian, but she makes the best goddamn apple pie I ever ate in my life.
It is good, isn't it?
A cook? He hired a cook? Well, now that don't make any sense. We don't eat.
That sounds healthy.
We eat cheese and saltines, a ham sandwich. But I don't remember the last time that stove turned on. Years.
Now you get biscuits and gravy. It's a kind of nice stuff.
Nice for you now. But you'll be gone soon enough never to return.
Gone.
When was the last time you were here?
Don't get started on
this. No, really, I don't remember.
I am a very dutiful daughter, okay? I call, I write, I send presents.
You do not write!
I send presents on birthdays and Mother's Day.
Because you're dutiful.
Oh, don't you know.
All right, now.
You're grown-up people. Grown-ups! Go where you want.
I have a lot of obligations, Mom, okay? I have a daughter starting high school in just a couple of months.
That's right! Last time I saw her, she was grade school.
You know, I won't get started on this.
I don't care about you two, really. I would just like to see my granddaughter every now and again.
Well, you're seeing her now.
But your father broke his heart when you moved away.
That is wildly unfair.
All right, am I going to have to separate the two?
You know you were Beverly's
say, but don't pretend you don't know that.
And I don't want to know that, okay? I would prefer to think that my parents loved all their children equally.
Well, I'm sure you'd prefer to think that Santa Claus brought you your presents at Christmas, too, which isn't so. If you'd had more than one child, you would know a parent always has favorites. Now, Faye was my mom's favorite. Big deal. I got used to it. You were your father's.
Great. Thanks.
Broke his heart.
What was I supposed to do? Hey, Colorado offered Bill twice the money he was making at TU.
Wait, why?
And they were willing to hire me, too. Daddy knew we had to take those jobs. You think he wouldn't have jumped at the chance Bill got?
Oh, now you are wrong there. You never would have gotten Beverly out of Oklahoma, and don't think he didn't have his opportunities, too, after Meadowlark came out.
I'm sure.
After Meadowlark was published, he had job offers from all over the country. Oh, it's better places than Colorado.
So now we want to knock Colorado.
Well, it's not hard to do.
Barbara,
Daddy's book came out 40 years ago. Academia is very different now. It is extremely competitive.
Oh, please. Tell me all about Academia.
Daddy gave me his lesson and I didn't ask for it.
That's what he told you.
All right, we're all getting a little bit on edge.
So now you're going to tell me the true story. Some terrible shit Daddy said behind my back.
Beverly didn't say terrible things behind your back. He just told me he was disappointed in you because you settled.
Is that supposed to be a comment on Bill? Daddy never said anything like that.
Your father thought you had talent as a writer.
If he did, and I doubt that's true, he was wrong. Anyways, what difference does it make? It's my life. I can do what I want. So he was disappointed in me because I settled for a beautiful family and a teaching career. Is that what you're saying? Absolute horseshit!
Oh, horseshit! Horseshit! Everyone say horseshit! Say horseshit, Bill!
Horseshit.
Are you high?
No.
No, are you high? I mean, literally, are you taking something?
A muscle relaxer.
Listen to me. I will not go through this with you again.
Go through what?
These fucking pills!
Yeah, muscle relaxer!
I will not go through this with you again!
I don't know what you're talking about.
The psych ward calls at 3 a.m. about people in your backyard.
Oh, you are so much
trouble! The police call the rest of it! You do know what I'm talking about. You spent a goddamn fortune on these fucking
stuff! Stop yelling at me!
And then you spent another fortune getting off of it!
It's not the same thing! I didn't have a reason!
Oh, now it's okay being hooked if you've got a reason.
I'm not hooked on anything!
I'm not saying you are not. I'm just saying I will not go through this with you again.
Oh, no! I'm in pain!
Mouth?
Yes! Because my mouth burns from the chemo.
You're in a lot of pain?
Yes! I got cancer in my mouth. And it burns like bullshit! And Beverly's disappeared. And you're yelling at me!
I'm yelling.
You couldn't come home when I got cancer, but the minute Beverly disappeared, you rushed right back.
I'm sorry, okay, look, right, Meg, look, I'm sorry. You know where I think he is? I think he got some whiskey, carton cigarettes, a couple of good spine on him, and he
He was retarded. Are your parents still together?
They passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's okay. Thank you. Oh, fuck. No, I'm really sorry. I feel fucking terrible now.
It's okay.
Oh, God. Okay. Were you close with them?
Yeah.
Okay, another stupid question there, Jean. Wow. Real good. Like, were you close with your parents?
Well, not everybody is.
Yeah, right? So that's what I meant. Thanks.
Oh, wow. That is them.
It's their wedding picture.
That's sweet. Their costumes are fantastic. This is a great room. Very Night of the Hunter. This used to be my room if you come and stay here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, it doesn't matter to me, it's just a room. What are you reading?
T.S. Eliot.
That's cool.
Your grandfather wrote it to
you. Grandpa? Is weird. Mom freaked when she got the phone call from Aunt Ivy this morning. Just like, freaked. I've never seen her like that before. I couldn't get her to calm down. It was weird. I guess it's not weird that she freaked out, but like, to see your mom freak like that? Like you've never seen before, you know? And we're real close. Did you ever see your parents freak out?
They weren't really the type.
Yeah, right? So, imagine they did just one day, like, totally lose their shit. Just like, whoa! I like your necklace.
Thank you.
Did you make that?
My grandma.
It's a turtle, right?
Mm-hmm.
It feels like there's something in it.
My vocal cord.
No! Are you serious? Oh my god, that's kind of gross.
It's not outstanding.
Why would you do that? Is that some kind of...
It's a Cheyenne tradition.
You're Cheyenne. Like that movie, Powwow Highway? Did you see that?
When a Cheyenne baby is born, our vocal cord is dried up and sewn onto its pouch. True is for girls, this is for boys. We wear it for the rest of our lives.
Wow.
And if we ever lose it, our soul belongs nowhere. And after we die, our soul will walk the earth looking for where it belongs.
Don't say anything about Mom and Dad splitting, okay? They're trying to play this cool.
But I'm not going to be held hostage in this room so you can attack me.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hold you hostage.
going anywhere. I flew to Oklahoma to be with you, and now you're stuck. And her name is Sid.
I know her stupid name. At least give me the courtesy of recognizing when I'm demeaning you.
You know, Violet really has a way of putting you in attack mode.
She has nothing.
Oh, don't you believe that. You feel so much rage for her, you just can't help petition my direction.
I swear to God, psychoanalyze me right now, I'm going to skin you.
You may not agree with my methods, but you know I'm right.
Your methods? Well, thank you, doctor. But I really don't need any help for my mother to feel rage.
Do you want to argue? Is that what you need to do? Well, pick a subject and let me know what it is so at least I have a fighting chance.
The subject is me. I am the subject, you narcissistic motherfucker. I am in pain. I need help.
I've cop to being a narcissist. We're the products of a narcissistic generation.
You can't do it, Kenny. You can't talk about me for 2 seconds.
You called me a narcissist. And every time I try and talk about you, you accuse me of psychoanalyzing.
You do understand that it hurts, right? To go from sharing a bed with you for 16 years sleeping by myself?
I'm here now.
Men always say shit like that! As if the past and the future don't exist!
You know, can we not make this a gender discussion?
We demand really believe that here and now is enough. It's just horseshit to avoid talking about things that they're afraid to say.
You know, I'm not necessarily keen on the notion of saying things that would hurt me.
Like what?
Don't!
What? Say it. You must realize there's nothing you can say to hurt me any more than I'm already hurt you. Damage is done.
No, I think you're wrong. I think you actually get this masochistic frame of mind that desires to be hurt more.
What?
Barbara, please. We have enough going on right now with your parents. Let's not revisit this.
Revisit this? When did we visit this to begin with? When you pulled the rug out from under me, I still don't know what happened. But do I bore you, intimidate you, and disgust you? Or is this just about the pleasures of young flesh, teenage pussy? I really need to know.
You need to know now? If you want to have this discussion with Beverly missing, your mother is crazy as a loon, and our daughter 20 feet away. You really want to do this now?
You're right. I'll just hunker down for a cozy night's sleep next to my husband.
Look, this discussion deserves our care. Patience. We'll both be in a better frame of mind to talk about this once your father's come home.
My father's dead, Bill.
Hooked Mr. Weston and pulled him up.
Wait, now, this time of night?
Those guys went on those lines earlier.
Did he drown? He died from drowning?
Yes, sir.
Is there any possibility? I mean, any possibility that it's not him?
Given the proximity to the boat where Mr. West's body was found, we're pretty sure it's him.
Okay. All right, if something happens next, what do we do now?
I need a relative to come with me to positively identify the body.
To the station house?
No, sir, he's still late.
I think I can do this.
I'll go. Can I do it?
I need a blood relative. But if Barbara's the one to come, I suggest you come along.
No, I can't do it.
Sweetheart, what choice do we have?
I can do it. I'm a blood relative.
No. That's okay. No, I can do it. I will.
Can we have a few minutes to get ready?
Yes, sir. Barbara, I'm very sorry. This is the hardest part of my job. To do it to someone I know is just... I'm very sorry. Barbara.
What are we going to do about your mother?
Fuck
you.
I guess I'll just
go
put some clothes on.
I'll be right up. Jean, take care of your mother. So, is there any way to determine whether this was an accident or suicide?
There's really no way to tell.
What do you think happened? What's your guess?
Suicide? I would guess suicide, but the official cause of death is drowning. Lasting steadily.
I understand.
I should warn you that the body's been in the water for all 3 days.
Right.
I think you should try and prepare your wife if you can.
Prepare?
What happens to the body is, it's very bloated. It's ugly color. Fish have eaten the eyes.
Oh, Christ. How does a person just jump in the water and choose not to swim?
Well, I don't think you do unless you really mean business.
Choose not to swim?
What about Aunt Ivy?
Guess we'll stop by on the way back and tell her. Shit, I need to call Carrie too. What the fuck was I about to do my hair for?
I used to go out with that boy. That man.
What man?
The sheriff.
You did?
Yeah, back in high school, he was my prom date.
You're kidding.
But now he's here telling me.
It's just so surreal. And thank God we can't tell the future. We'd never get out of bed.
Listen to me.
Die after me, all right? I don't care what else you do, where you go, how you screw up your life. Just survive. Outlive me, please.
I'll try my best.
Are you ready?
Give me a minute.
Is a story.
Hello, Violet.
Barely's back.
I beg your pardon?
Did some barely come home?
Ma'am?
Is a city. Six Z's. In architects?
Come on, bro! Thank you.